Hi everyone, here in this video we're going to talk about how to start receiving orders from e-commerce system to Odoo. I will show you an example of PrestaShop connector, but algorithm and logic is the same for PrestaShop, WooCommerce, Shopify and Magento. So before receiving orders, we highly recommend you to finish initial import to receive all the objects and link them between Odoo and e-commerce system, and also to finish import of products and link them. So to start receiving products, we are simply going to the automation jobs and need to activate enable order import. After that, a special scheduled action will be activated. We can find it here, receive orders. As you can see, it's executing every 5 minutes, but this value can be changed. And it's checking if new orders appeared in the e-commerce system, which are matching to our order status filter. You can specify status filter for orders in the quick configuration wizard and to see the current value in this table. Receive order filter, here it is. Another option how to receive orders from e-commerce system into Odoo is using webhooks. Independent on the e-commerce system, in some e-commerce system it's necessary a special plugin for receiving orders, but in some of them it's working by default. So you simply clicking on create webhooks, and these webhooks for creating order or even for updating statuses will be created. And you can check the login by activating these checkboxes. Now some words about from what data you are planning to receive orders. For example, if you are planning to go live, but you want to receive orders from the beginning of the year. To do it, you are going to the orders cutoff date field, specify here, for example, 1st January 2024, click on apply, and the next job will start receiving orders from this data. And if it's matching to our status filter, they will appear in the external orders data. So let's go to this menu. Here we can see that we received one order. We received information in the JSON format. And if the order was successfully created, we can simply click on open sell order button and we will see our order. So here we can see information about products, discounts, shipping if it exists in this sell order, taxes, totals and so on. As you can see, the customer was automatically created, the customer and invoice and delivery address. And by default, we create an order in the quotation status, but this behavior could be specified. For that, we have specific functionalities or special functionality, auto workflow, where you go into the configuration, order statuses. And here we can see the list of all statuses, in my case, it's for PrestaShop, and for each of them, I can specify the necessary behavior. For example, if I receive an order in the shipped status, I can automatically confirm it by activating these checkboxes, validate delivery if there is enough stock, create invoice, I need to specify also invoice journal if I want to validate invoice and register payments, and so on. So in this table, you can specify different auto workflow for different statuses. And this is how it works. Additionally, you can find more configuration in the sale orders tab. Here it is. You can specify product, which will be used as a discount if products have some discount lines. Price different products for positive and negative. It's mostly for rounding issues. You can choose the behavior for numbering. For example, you can also use sell order numbering for orders which will be coming from PrestaShop or another e-commerce system. Or even you can specify a prefix to define the orders which are coming from e-commerce system into order. Also, you can find all these orders in the sell tab. Here it is, so it's visible from here and from e-commerce external order data. So that's all for today. Thank you.